But yeah, sige, laban lang ta. All right, sige. So for this week, okay, what we're going to discuss is your nematodes. Okay, finally, no, we're done with your protozoa, no? We're finally done with protozoa, and now we're going to start with the metazoa. Okay, so metazoa, or also known as your helminths. Okay, so wait na. Gamit ang board. Okay. Alright, madunggan ako, dears. Okay ra? Makita na po ko. Makita akong fans. Sir. Okay ra? Can you
okay, sir.
Okay ra? Okay, sige. So, please tell me if makita ra ha. So again, metazoa, also known as your helminths. Okay? Helminths comes from the Greek word helminths. Ayan. Helminths, meaning intestinal worm. So muna siya yung origin. Okay? So your metazoa or helminths. So muna siya itong i-focus karon na week. Now your helminths, anyway, so your helminths, no, metazoa, in comparison or in contrast to your protozoa, these are now the multicellular, no, multicellular parasites na to, and most of the time these are your worms, okay? So these are your worms, no. So again, baliktanin na flow chart, no. So we're here na na side, na nata sa right side, metazoans, so almost done, no. And the metazoans or helminths, again, helminths, from the Greek word helminths, meaning intestinal worm. Again, kani sila are divided into three major groups na itong i-discuss. Okay? First is the nematodes, okay, which is our topic this week, followed by the trematodes, and then finally, cestodes. Now, nematodes, sa kong erase it. Choke, sorry. Nematodes is under your phylum. Kapulanan ako, igaling ko. So, nematode is under the phylum Nemathelminthes. Okay. And then your trematodes and cestodes, they are all under one phylum, and that is Platyhelminthes, no? By the name itself, Platy, because usually flatworms and your tapeworms are flat na worms, no? Flat nilahang appearance, alright? So, Platyhelminthes ang imuhang cestodes and trematodes, and then Nemathelminthes ang imuhang nematodes. Okay? So what we're focusing now for this week are your nematodes. Okay. Alright. Sige. Sige. Next. So we go now to your general characteristics of nematodes. Now, nematodes, by the name itself, sila gini mga murag original gyud na worm. No? Ilahang appearance is the characteristic appearance good of your worm. No? They are elongated, cylindrical, and bilaterally symmetrical. So when we say bilaterally symmetrical, if a half nimo yung body, again, they can be divided into two equal parts. Okay? So, elongated. Ayan pa. Ano ba yan? Worm ba to, sir? Or ano? Semi-formed stool. Charot. Eme. Joke lang. Ito, elongated, cylindrical worms. No? So, sila yun ng na-eye characteristic appearance na worm. No? Kanang earthworm. No? Usually, close relative ng nematodes, mga earthworms. Ayan. So, elongated, cylindrical worms, primarily bilaterally symmetrical. Next, the anterior end or front may contain mga teeth, no? May contain hooks, plates, or papillae for abrasion, for attachment, and even sensory purposes. So sa front nila, of course, they could have a mouth, no? They could have mouth parts like teeth, hooks, usually used for attachment or for abrasion, no? So, but nasa lang mga other parts po, no? So dili na siya body ragyon. Nasa lang mouth, nasa lang teeth, and all that. Next, the supporting body consists of an outer hyaline cuticle, an epithelium after that, and then layer of muscle cells. So you have three layers usually of the body's a worm, okay? And it's quite simple na structure, okay? All right. Next, alimentary tract or yung digestive tract is simple. Usara jud siya ka tract, no? Or usara siya ka road, your road charot. Usara siya ka way, no? From mouth to anus, usara gyud. Complete digestive tract, and there's also a muscular pharynx that is characteristically triradiate. So, example, muna siya triradiate. As you can see sa picture, dears, ayan, sa tunga, this is the pharynx. So, as you can see, triradiate because they form siya og murag triangle. Okay? So, triradiate. Alright. So, in any yahang appearance, siyang pharynx, pag ato siya i-cross-section, ang worm. Okay? So, triradiate. Wala siya circulatory system. So, ayan. So, simple, regular, digestive tract and then the pharynx, triradiate. Okay. So very simple, mouth, of course, dramusulod ang char. mouth is the entry for food, and the anus is for disposal. No, so very simple lang from the start to the end, mouth to anus lang. So very simple. Okay. Next, you have it consists of a complete reproductive system. Now, very important to take note, dears, that in your nematodes, sa tuluka groups usually, sa tuluka groups of your helminths, the nematodes na group yun ang dioecious. So when you say dioecious, it's something possible sa meaning na dioecious. They have separate sexes, meaning na adyo yung usaka worm na male, na po yung usaka worm na female. All right. In contrast to your cestodes and trematodes, most of your cestodes and trematodes are monoecious. So when you say monoecious, they are hermaphroditic, no? So when you say hermaphroditic, naaras sa usaka worm ang both male and female genital organs. Makita ra, dears? Okay ra? Or medyo dili klaro? Yes? Okay ra?
Okay ra, sir.
Klaro ra, sir.
Sige, thank you. Salamat sa pag-acknowledge. Okay, ayan. So again, so your nematodes, again, this group of your helminths, sila yun ang dioecious. So we say dioecious again, say pasabot, they have separate sexes, meaning one worm is the male and the other worm is the female. In contrast to the trematodes and cestodes, the other groups of your helminths, sila yun, na duha ka groups ang mostly monoecious or hermaphroditic. So we say monoecious or hermaphroditic, they only have both of the genital organs, male and female, are found in one worm. Okay? So take note of that. All right. Sige. Life cycle, please take note, is egg stage, of course. Egg, followed by the larval stage, which is usually mga 4 stages, and you have the adult stage. Now, your larval stages are also known as your juvenile. Pa, diba? Juvenile delinquency. Charep. So juvenile, by the name itself, juvenile, ang point sa juvenile is, diba, parang teenager. Ayan. Teenager na stage sa imuhang worm, no? Larva, juvenile. Okay. Now, larva stages could be 4. Muna siya, ang kabantay muna ay L1, no? L2, L3, and L4, no? So, of course, ang L1 magsugod, alright? Now, once the worm is at L1, larva 1, first stage, mumolt siya, okay? When you say molt, no? Iyahang tangtangon, iyahang outer cuticle, and then mo change na po. So, muna siya, kana mo sa snake gani na mo shed sa skin inana pod ang mga worms or nematodes, they have molting, no? Molt, okay? So after first larva, mumolt siya, tantangon niya ang outer cuticle kay basin to change the antigen sa surface or in contact with other environment para maka-adapt siya, no? So iyahang i-change ang iyahang molt. So mahimo na siyang L2 this time. And then molting na pod, mahimong L3, and then finally, last na molt is usually padulong na sa L4. And then after L4, which is the 4th stage larva, padulong na siya ang adult. Okay? So, inana yung maturation. So, egg, okay? And then 4 stages of larva, and then finally adult. Okay? And again, the 4 stages of larva usually happens after every molt. No? Again, we say molt, mag-change yung skin, no? Mag-change yung cuticle, di ba? Outer portion sa worm. Okay? So, mara siya a new person. Parang ganung level. Ganun. Okay? So, I am a new person, no? Change na siya, ganun. Okay? So, mag-change yung cuticle from time to time, and that is a molt, no? Molting. That's a process of molting. Okay? Alright. And usually, sa ato ang mga nematodes na important, usually atong gina-look after is L1 and your L3. Okay? So, L1 and L3, the odd numbers na mga larval stages. So, si L1 and si L3. Usually, sila atong ma-detect sa itong mga samples, okay? Sa itong mga clinical samples, and we also use para maka-identify na ito. Para ma-identify sila, okay? Alright, ayan, sige. Next, you have, as I mentioned, they are dioecious, okay? But again, naay uba na parthenogenetic. So meaning, it doesn't need a male counterpart para maburos siya or for it to be fertilized, okay? Ayan, parthenogenetic. So kinsa na siya? Of course, si Strongyloides, Stercoralis. Nako, di ba siya itong strong, independent, woman, yes. Pwede siyang na-i-lucky, pwede pong wala para ma-fertilize siya. Okay. Diba? Pwede siyang, usually parthenogenetic, I'd like to think of it as immaculate conception. Ganun. Okay? So, wala siya, wala yung sex na naitabo, no? Fertilization happened, or naburo siya, or it produced larva on its own. Pag ganun. Okay? Ayan. So, may or may not require a male. Female, usually, of course, sila ang ma-produce sa eggs. Okay? And usually for your nematodes, ang female gud ang larger compared to your male, okay? And the male contains the spicule, and this spicule is usually the reproductive organ. So kaning spicule is in a way muna siya ang penis sa male, siya ang mo deposit og sperm no to the female, all right? So usually in size no, females gid ang larger. So strong independent woman gid no. Women empowerment ta diri sa nematodes. Amen. Yes, female ang larger compared to your male. All right. Okay, sige. Next, you have again female worms produce eggs. Now, depende siya sa imuhang type of worms. So again, they're classified either oviparous. So we say oviparous, the eggs nagi-lay sa imuhang worms are still unembryonated, meaning wala pa sila nagsugod o divide para himong para mahimong larva. Okay? So pag-lay nila sa environment, example, it's still unembryonated, all right, or unsegmented, meaning wala pa siya divisions, no, cell divisions, padulong sa larva. Okay? And usually what happens is sa environment na sila or sa soil ba, example for Ascaris, dito na sila mo mature or dito na sila magka-produce og embryo inside the egg. Okay? That's oviparous. Next, you have oviviparous or ovoviviparous. So we say ovoviviparous, pag lay sa eggs, no, the eggs already contains larva. Okay? So dili na siya kailangan mag-divide, no, ang cells inside the egg para mahimong larva. Pag lay dayon sa egg, sa female, sa environment ba or wherever, the egg already contains larva. Okay? So embryonated or mature eggs. Alright? So example, very good example is Enterobius vermicularis. So later we'll look into that. And lastly, viviparous or larviparous. So instead of eggs, iyahang ilay, mulay ra siya og larva agad-agad. Okay? So dili eggs ang ihatag. So example na is si Trichinella spiralis. So later, when we go to the tissue nematodes, ato i-discuss si Trichinella spiralis. Okay? So again, nasa pangalan na, ovo, di ba parang it talks about egg? Ovo, oviparous, sorry. So iyahang ilay na egg kay not mature pa, no? Wala pa developing or wala pa na-develop ang larva sa sulod. Next, you have oviviparous or ovoviviparous. Pag lay niya sa egg, ang sulod sa egg is the larva already. Okay? So, wala na nag-mature. Wala na, hindi na kailangan mag-mature sa soil. Diba? Ganun. So, pag lay sa egg, ang sulod sa egg kay larva agad-agad. Alright? Next, viviparous, of course, larva ang ilay. Wala na yung egg na stage. Okay? So, larva dahil ang ilay sa females, wala na yung egg. Alright? I hope na-gets right to siya. Alright. Okay. Sige. Next, they could also have sensory organs, all right, which are your chemoreceptors, which they use to communicate with the environment para makabalo sa life, okay lang ang environment, and also to communicate if with other worms, no, in terms of their community and in terms of living together, ganun, ayan. So, pwede siya sa anterior and posterior ends. They're called amphids or pwedeng phasmids, all right. Now, those with aphasmids, meaning wala sila yung phasmids, you have Trichuris, Trichinella, and Capillaria. And those that contains the phasmids are the rest of your nematodes. So take note, Trichuris, Trichinella, and Capillaria, they don't have phasmids. So they are aphasmids. Alright? And usually, they, kanisilang tulo, they belong to the same family. Alright? Ayan, Trichuris, Trichinella, and Capillaria. Alright, okay. So those are the general characteristics of your nematodes. Okay. Now we go now to their classification based on habitat of your adult worms. Now take note, for small intestine, unsa tong mnemonics, cached. Okay? Cached. Okay? Ayan, I don't have this. Ang sad. Cached, no? Cached means Capillaria, Ascaris, Strongi, hookworm, and Trichinella spiralis adult. They live in your small intestine, okay? Large intestine is your ET, Enterobius vermicularis, and Trichuris. Extraintestinal nematodes, of course, meaning outside the intestines. You have lymph nodes and lymph vessel. Your filarial worms, no? Wuchereria and Brugia and the rest. You have eyes and meninges. You have Angiostrongylus cantonensis. And insisted in the host muscle, please take note, is Trichinella spiralis larva. So, di ba? We have a question sa pre-test, if ma-remember pa. The habitat of the adult Trichinella spiralis, again, asa makitaan, sa small intestine. So, please take note ha, kung adult gani kay small intestine for Trichinella spiralis. But, if ang question kay larva of Trichinella spiralis, asa makitaan, sa muscles, skeletal muscles, no? Insisted in skeletal muscles. Okay? Please take note ha sa questioning. Kaya usually man good, di ba, as I've mentioned, if magsigi na tagtuon-tunog para, makomo na nato siya na, ah, okay, Trichinella spiralis, press the buzzer, sa muscle na siya. Okay? So, natay, mabuta na level. Okay? Mabot mo na level yun, na magtuon mo na marag, ah, okay, Trichinella spiralis, muscle ni siya. But again, take note ha, depende sa question. Kung adult ang ipamuta na, sa itong answer, small intestine. But kung larva, atong answer kay, dapat, host muscle. Okay? Please take note. Please take note. Okay. Ayan. Sige. Alright. Sige. Alright. So, any questions before we start now with the first type of your nematodes? Medyo marami rin tayong chichikahin talaga. Woo! Sana naman. Matapos today. But anyway, alright. So far, nag-gets lang. Alright? So again, asa makitaan ang adult Trichinella spiralis?
Small intestine.
Okay. Bakit parang ano? Pagod na pagod yun, Erla. Okay. Next, you have, asa gani makitaan ang larva sa Trichinella spiralis? Insisted in the host muscle or sa skeletal muscles. Okay, very good. Alright, so we'll now start with your intestinal nematodes. So by the name itself, these are the nematodes that infect, alright, or that cause infection usually sa itong intestines or sa itong digestive tract. Okay, of course, starting first with our, with the lifespan. No? So as you can see, magwala na siya yung notes. Sige lang, ako rin pong i-post ng PowerPoint after we're done. So as you can see, the lifespan of your most common intestinal nematodes, it varies, no, depending on the species and depending po on their worm burden, meaning unsa sila kadaghan, if heavy bang infection or dili, and also their ability to really cause infections in muhang body, no, and their ability to cause reinfection or autoinfection. So as you can see, those that are capable of reinfection or autoinfection, usually sila ang mudugay, no, because again, when you say autoinfection, sige lang gabalik-balik within the host ang infection. So, magsigirag balik-balik ang worm o infect, so therefore, pwede siyang mudugay. No? Sana all. Charat, ayan. So, as you can see, Strongyloides, 30 plus years, o diba, grabe yun. Because again, capable siyang auto-infection. So, meaning, if the patient is infected with Strongy, pwede siyang ma-infect na pud balik. Gikan sa iyang own lawas ra pud. Okay? So, auto-infection. Okay? Alright, ayan. So, Ascaris, Enterobius trichuris, hookworms, and Strongy. So, the most common. So, as you can see, medyo lifespan, ang Ascaris kay medyo short lang yun. Kay once mawala na mga adults sa imuhang intestines, of course, wala na eggs na ma-produce. Alright? So, pwede siyang ma-abort na yun, ang yahang lifespan. Okay? But compared to the rest, because they're capable of auto-infection, reinfection, pwede silang mudugay. Alright? Sana all. No? Mudugay. Char. Okay. Of course, we're going to start first with the very common, ang best friend ng lahat. And actually, kini siyang pinaka- like murag like makita akong stool sample dire sa Philippines and then kanina siya ko makita like murag wala bang iba diyan. So, this is Ascaris, of course. Ascaris lumbricoides, ayan. So this is considered to be the most common intestinal nematode of man. But please take note aning description dears ha, because in every references na akong gibasa and every reference ko na akong na read mo differ gud siya na uban na. The most common intestinal nematode worldwide is Enterobius. Na po yung ibang resources that the most common intestinal nematode of mine is Ascaris. So, we'll have to settle that later kung unsa giyod. Alright? So, if ever magani mo question siya or igawa siya na question, unsa itong i-answer. Okay? Sige. Alright. So, most common intestinal nematode of mine is considered to be Ascaris. I think gikan ni siya sa Belisario. Sa Belisario ni siya na line, I think. If I'm not mistaken. And then it occurs most frequently in the tropics, usually tropics. Of course, kita, we're in the tropics, okay? Because, partly because sa yahang requirement sa eggs para mo mature siya. So again, it's considered to be the largest nematode affecting man. Ayan, please take note. Kanisha, wala nang duda. It's the largest nematode affecting man. Please take note, ha? The largest nematode infecting man. Next, ayan, kanisha na part yun, makatawa ko, no? Because, mura, kanisha na part, marina siya katong, kanang part kanisa yearbook. Naibutang mo ang mga orgs or mga curriculum vitae ba, CV, para if mo speaker ka or whatever. So, muna siya yahang mga achievements ni Ascaris. So, muna yahang mga BS org na involvement. So, si Ascaris, members of the Soil Transmitted Helminths na organization, charot, ayan. So, STH, or we have a mnemonics for that, the HATS, no? And then, member of the Unholy Three, ayan, which is, atong mnemonic is HAT. And then, lastly, the member of the parasites that exhibit heart to lung migration, ash. Ayan. Later, ito na ipang-define ng kinsa ng mga HATS, HAT, and ash. Please take note, kanina mga mnemonic sa para, kanang HATS, HAT, and ash, nako, gas-gas na gas-gas. Very press the buzzer na dapat yarn, kanina silang tulo. Okay? Alright, ayan, sige. So, muna siya ang, ano ha, BS org, org involvement ni Ascaris, no? So, ayan. So, muna siya yung sulod siyang yearbook, charot. Okay, di na siya funny, charot. Ayan. So, kamo dear sa next sem, where magsugod na mo picture for portal. Oh my God! So, I'm so excited. Ayan, I'm so excited. So, try your best na to, ano, magkalkal na mo sa inyong mga org involvements, sa inyong mga achievements, and then, basugo na mo sa inyong pa-pretty sa picture, charot dito. Hapit na na, hapit na na. Let's claim that, okay? Dapat yun makaportal and makapaso. Amen, amen. Alright, sige. Alright, now we go na to, ayan. So ako na siyang i-table para dali na tangtanan, no? Alright. So common name, ayan. Diri, I have to emphasize again, balik, the common names, no? So I think na-mention na ako sa start pag yun sa para na, again, common names, lumalabas pa rin sa boards. And once mo gawas na sa boards, one point na mag-praise the Lord, hallelujah na ta. Because again, one point na siya. So again, kita, since we're learning para, very important yun nato nang i-memorize by heart ang mga common names. Alright? So for Ascaris, the common name is of course the giant intestinal roundworms. Okay? Or roundworm. So nasa pangalan na, giant intestinal roundworm. That's why, siya po ang largest nematode. So nematodes are also known as your roundworms, dear. Okay? So nematodes or roundworms. So Ascaris, giant intestinal roundworm. Ako, press the buzzer na yun. As in, very easy. Alright. Habitat is in the small intestine. Final host is kita, no man. Diagnostic stage is your ova or the eggs may be fertilized or unfertilized. Alright? Infective stage is embryonated egg. So please take note, ha? The infective stage is embryonated egg. So that's why, sa next row, mode of transmission, the mode of transmission is fecal-oral. Okay? Ingestion of embryonated eggs. But again, if ang soil, usually you can sa soil, if the soil does not contain embryonated eggs, ang makuha nimo kay unembryonated, then of course, hindi siya makakause og infection. Okay? So it's best, para di makakause og infection, dapat embryonated egg imuhang makaon. Meaning, ang sulod yun mismo kay nag-develop na siya pa larva. Okay? Alright, ayan. Sige. Alright. And vectors, possible vectors are flies and cockroaches. No, so these can be these are mechanical vectors, okay? Because again, usually they transmit eggs, no? Pwede ang eggs sa Ascaris mutapot nila, no? And usually kani sila mag, di ba, maglupad-lupad or mag-crawl from one area to another. So while they crawl or fly to one area to another, they can bring the eggs with them, no? So ayan, so especially if sa soil, di ba, usually sa soil man makuha ang Ascaris na eggs and ay mga feces dito, so mudapo ang flies especially or cockroaches, madala po nilang eggs. So, pwede silang mechanical vectors, okay? That's why I don't like cockroaches. Pero, magbinasos ba ko? Charot. Minus the roaches, okay lang. Charot, joke lang. Check, check. Ang bastos, eme. Charot, joke lang. Okay, ayan, sige. So, these are the more mga important stuff about Ascaris, ha? Common name, habitat, final host, diagnostic stage, okay? Infective stage. For diagnostic stage, again, ova most of the time. But, there are some samples na pwedeng makuha po ng adult, okay? So, I don't know if you've experienced, pero nakachika na ko ani, sa ako ang friend, no, sa ilang public health sa una, apil sa sample, nagihatag sa bata, stool sample, no, is the adult Ascaris. So, maklaro dyan kayo siya, dako kaayo siya. Okay? So, usually, if nakay mga stool sample na madawat in the laboratory or pag-process ninyo, and ay adult worm na apil, then most of the time, that is Ascaris. Because the adult of Ascaris is usually big, no? Giant intestinal roundworm. Makitan yun siya, no? Unlike your Trichuris or Enterobius or the rest of your nematodes na common, usually the adults, if naman gani, are small. Dili kayo siya makita, macroscopic, okay? Pero makitan siya sa surface, ginagmay ng mga worms. Pero unlike Ascaris, nadako dyan na worm ba? Namurag, gibutangan dyan siya earthworm ang stool sample. Yan na siya kadako, okay? Ayan, so that's for the important stuff about Ascaris. Again, take note, ha? Mode of transmissions, infective stage, common names, very important, diagnostic stage po. Okay? All right, ayan. Sige. Now, we go now to adults. Okay, your adults can be white, cream, or pinkish-yellow ang iyahang color when fresh. Ayan, so yun na yung appearance. As you can see, mas dako dyan ang female compared to your male. All right? Next, the head contains three lips. That's why it's called trilobate. Okay? Or triangular iyahang buccal cavity. Ayan. So here's an example. So as you can see, tulo ka lips, no? Ang pangit tingnan, charot. May, parang may na-remember ako sa appearance. Charot, joke. Ayan. So again, three lips, no? Trilobate, triangular buccal cavity. So take note also, dear, as you can see, ang male, alright, na siya iyahang end. This is the spicule. It's curved, okay? So curved iyahang posterior end. So in order to differentiate the two, example lang, makakuha ka sa imuhang sample ng adults. If you want to know if it's male or female Ascaris, then look at the posterior end. So if makakita ka na curved ang posterior end, then that is your male. Alright? And by size, again, mas dako ang female compared to male. As we have mentioned ganina sa start, for nematodes, ang females yun ang dagko compared to males. Alright? Okay, ayan. And again, characteristic three lips, usually triangular buccal cavity or trilobate. Usually mga Ascaris and other families, other worms related to Ascaris, three lips gina sila. Okay? Trilobate. Okay? All right, ayan, sige. That's for the eggs, ayan, of course. For the eggs, they become effective 2 to 6 weeks after deposition. So as you can see, that's why Ascaris is oviparous, no? Oviparous. Because pag lay sa eggs, especially sa environment, dili siya infective dayon. Meaning, kailangan pa siya mature in the environment, again, 2 to 6 weeks. All right? Okay. Next, it can survive harsh environments, pwedeng dry or freezing temperatures. They can be either fertile or fertilized or infertile. Okay. Lecithin granules is present in unfertilized egg. Lecithin granules usually are used for nourishment, no? And for other, for metabolism than si muhang egg. Okay. All right. Now, the eggshell consists of 3 layers. Na siya 3 layers. You have the inner vitellin, lipoidal or lecithin later. Layer na siya dear, sorry. Layer. It's not found in unfertilized egg. So, inner na siya na layer. Next, you have the middle glycogen layer. And then finally, the outer mammillation or corticated layer. So, this is made of albumin and it's usually used for protection. So, kanina mga layers usually are for protection or for nourishment of the egg. Especially that mo develop ang larva inside the egg. Okay, so it needs protection and of course, it needs nourishment. So, sa mga layers, akong mnemonic anak kay VGC. Ayan, maraming mga gusto pumunta sa VGC. Charot. So, VGC, di ba? You have vitelline, ang inner, followed by glycogen, and then finally the cortication, no? Or corticated layer. So, VGC. Or pwede pong VGM. Bugan ka. So, VGM. So, vitelline, glycogen, and M is mammillation or corticated layer. VGC, VGM. Okay? So, those are the layers of your Ascaris eggs. Okay? All right, but please take note that both your fertilized and unfertilized eggs can contain this corticated layer or pwede pong wala. All right? So, both fertilized and unfertilized eggs can possess the corticated or mammillation layer or pwede pong wala. Okay? And once naasya ng corticated layer, we describe that as corticated, di ba? And if wala siya yung mammillation or the corticated layer, then we describe that as decorticated. Okay? Alright, ayan, sige. So we look now at the different types of eggs. Ayan, first with unfertilized eggs. Now, the unfertilized eggs, please take note, ang shape niya is elliptical or oblong. Most of the time, no, they are not round. So it's elliptical or oblong. Pataas siya, no? Oval. Alright. Now, it's narrower and longer. And it has a thinner shell with an irregular coating of your albumin. So, inanayahang appearance, no? Again, it's oblong, no? It's pataas, no? Elliptical or oval. So, these are your pictures. Ayan. So, of course, as you can see, kanang murag bumpy layers outside, no? Or murag wrinkled, that is the cortication or the mammillation, okay? And once inanayahang appearance, then we describe that as corticated, unfertilized egg of Ascaris. Basta gani pataas ang shape, all right, oval or elliptical, then that is unfertilized egg of Ascaris. And as you can see, ayan, sa, this is the decorticated. As you can see, ang outer appearance niya kay smooth, walay mga bumpy or mag walay mga nodules na appearance or mag walay mga buslot-buslot or mag wala siya'y bumps, okay, iyahang appearance, then that's decorticated. Okay, meaning wala siya tong, wala siya ning C or M na layer. Okay? So, wala siya outer mammillation or corticated layer. Alright? So, that's for unfertilized eggs. Again, how I distinguish between unfertilized or fertilized, it's through the shape. Okay? But na yung mga unfertilized eggs na round pod ang iyahang appearance. Okay? But most of the time, they are elliptical or oblong. Narrower in shape. Alright? Okay. Next, you have, of course, the fertilized eggs. Now, for fertilized eggs, sila ang round in appearance. No? They are more rounded than the unfertilized egg. It contains now a chitin shell or chitin shell, sandwich or chitin. No to chitin, charot. Okay. Sandwiched in between the embryo and the mammillated albuminous material. Because again, to protect the embryo from environment. And you have the corticated, as mentioned. If the eggs lack, they don't contain the mammillated albuminous coating, then the eggs are described as decorticated. Ayan. So always bile stained, meaning they are golden brown in color because in contact with the patient's bile, no? Sa small intestine sila, di ba? Nag-reside. So, bile is secreted sa small intestine, mo-react siya with the eggs, giving the eggs color golden brown. Okay, so bile stain. Ayan. So, here's an example. As mentioned, fertilized and unfertilized eggs can be both decorticated or corticated. So, here at first, this is your decorticated fertilized egg. So, as you can see, ang outer appearance niya kay smooth ra, no? Wala siya tong rough, bumpy appearance. In comparison, of course, this is your corticated fertilized egg. So as you can see, ang outer appearance niya kanina yung mga bumps, no? So that is the outer mammillation ng mga layers. Okay? All right. So please take note, ha. I hope na gets lang ang difference. Basta decorticated, the outer appearance kay smooth, okay, wala siyang mga bumps. And then corticated, again, na yung mga bumps na. And medyo rough na iyang appearance. Now, both fertilized and unfertilized eggs can be decorticated or corticated. Okay? Now, how do we distinguish? Usually, it's through shape, no? Kung round ang appearance sa egg, then that is most of the time fertilized. Okay? But if elliptical siya or oval ang appearance, narrower po siya and longer, then that is unfertilized egg of Ascaris. Okay? Alright. Now, both fertilized and unfertilized eggs can also be recovered at the same time in a sample. Okay? So, pwedeng na ay fertilized and unfertilized eggs ay muhang sample. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Sige. So, that's for the eggs of your Ascaris. Again, the diagnostic stage of Ascaris. Usually, muna siya itong makita sa ito ang sample. So, press the buzzer na, no? So, makita na ito ni, ay my gosh, wala bang iba dyan? Nakakasawa. Charot. Ayan. Okay. Sige. Now, we go now to your life cycle. Now, for life cycle of your Ascaris, it's very straightforward. So, for Ascaris, as you can see, it starts with the soil, no? So, the soil plays an important role in the maturation of your eggs. Because your eggs like, okay, ganahan sila na ang soil kay warm at saka moist. Ayan. So, ganahan siyang init, no? Basa-basa. My gosh. Charot. Kasi may di ganahan. Charot. Warm, moist soil. So, dira siya mo mature. Once the soil is in that type of environment, warm at moist, it facilitates the maturation of your unembryonated eggs. Okay? So, as you can see, ayan, nag-start ta with the egg sa feces, di ba? Ayan, sa soil. So, again, warm, moist soil, the egg continues to divide, as you can see, ayan, nag-divide siya, to now produce the larva. Now, inside the larva is already the L3, alright? Now, let's say a human, okay, ma-contaminate iyang hands with the soil, or iyang food ba, or fecally contaminated, whatever. Pagkaon niya, of course, the eggs will then be digested in your small intestine, okay, and mugawas ang larva. Now, the larva, what happens, kaya i-penetrate imuhang intestine, okay, and mato siya sa circulation, okay? And mato siya sa first sa liver, of course, and then padayon gyapon sa blood circulation, mabot siya sa lungs, okay? Now, in the lungs, alright, mato siya sa alveoli, iyahang i-puncture gyapon ng alveoli, alright? And dito sa alveoli, because it's rich in oxygen, di ba, ang lungs, dito siya mature, okay? Ang iyahang, dito mahuman iyahang larval stages, okay? And after sa alveoli, mabot siya sa imong pharynx, sa throat, okay? And pagabot sa pharynx or throat, of course, makafeel ka na medyo itchy. So, medyo mag-cough ka, di ba? Atsara. Mabebe kayo ito na cough, but mag-cough ka, di ba? So, what happens is, pagabot niya sa pharynx, pag-cough niya, mumubalik na po siya sa small intestine. And in the small intestine, dito na siya mahimong adults, alright? And they now produce the eggs. That is what we mentioned kanina, that is what we call the heart-to-lung migration. Because after sa intestine, muadto sa siya sa lungs, and then sa heart, para again, mature siya or mahuman iyahang larval stages. Okay? And after sa heart o lungs, mabot siya sa pharynx, sa imuhang throat. And because diba, itchy man dyan na, like, imun dyan na i-cough, diba? So what happens, kay, mubalik siya sa imuhang small intestine. And the small intestine, since humana iyahang larval stage, mahimo na siyang adult pagbalik niya sa small intestine. Okay? And pagabot niya sa small intestine, dito na siya mahimong adult, again, as mentioned, and then produce ng eggs, and the cycle goes on. Okay? So, ang point lang is, ni-migrate pag siya, nilaag pa siya, niato pa siya sa imuhang heart and lung. Muna siya heart to lung migration. Okay? Alright. So, I hope na-gets lang, ha? So, muna siya ang point sa heart to lung migration. So, kamo dyan, mga dears, basta may mga friends mo, sige, gaubo, sige, gatol ang throat na ko. Baka heart to lung migration na yan. Okay? So, take, ipacheck na ang stool, basta na na-ascaris. Charot, bitaw. Ayan. So, of course, it's itchy. Kaya mabot man ang larva dito. Diba? So, pag cough sa patient, ubalik ang larva sa small intestine, and then, the larva then becomes adults na. Alright? Okay, so, that's the life cycle of your Ascaris. It's considered to be indirect life cycle. Indirect life cycle ang Ascaris because ni adto pa siya different tissues before siya ni mature. Okay, di siya pareha sa uban na nematodes na sa small intestine ra magpundo, produce lang eggs, dito sila mahimong adults and then produce og eggs and then gawa sa environment. So mo siya direct na life cycle sa mga nematodes. But for Ascaris, it's usually considered or described as indirect life cycle. Okay? All right. So I hope na gets to siya. So ina na siya ka intense, no? Or dili siya ina na siya kalaagan imong Ascaris. Okay? All right. Ayan. So di ba, this is the letter A sa imong ash sa heart to lung migration. Okay. All right. Ayan. Sige. So that's for the life cycle of your ascaris. Okay. Now we go na to symptoms and pathology. Of course, the disease is known as ascariasis. Again, nanata sa mga nematodes ha. So I hope chakto ninyo pag-pronounce sa mga iasis. So ascariasis, no? Balantidiasis, no? Trichoriasis. Iasis ha, iasis. Dili ascariasis. Okay? Nako, sinasabi ko talaga. I'm watching you. I'm judging you, charot. Okay, ayan, sige. Sorry. Now, because your larva, muabot man siya sa lungs, okay, it can exhibit, or the patient can exhibit pneumonia-like symptoms. Pneumonia, cough, fever, and also eosinophils during the larval migration. There can also be vomiting and abdominal pain, especially if napasa sa intestines, alright? And there could be intestinal perforation. Because again, diba, as mentioned, pag kaon sa egg sa imuhang host, the larva will penetrate or will perforate your intestine, madto siya sa imuhang blood vessels para mabot siya sa heart and lungs, diba? Ayan. So intestinal perforation is possible. Now for larva, again, heart to lung migration, as mentioned, and atong mnemonic sign is ash. Ayan. Hello, Ash. Charot. Hello, Josh. Charot. Ayan. Ash. Ayan. So inyuhang classmate na si Ash. Okay? Ash. Okay. Now resembling what we call your Loewe-Fleurs syndrome. Okay? So Loewe-Fleurs syndrome or ascaris pneumonitis. So basically, this is an allergic reaction, no? So daghang eosinophils, pneumonia-like symptoms, cough, no? Ang symptoms sa patient because again of the larva found in the lungs. Okay, so that's called as Loewe-Fleurs syndrome or ascaris pneumonitis. Okay, increased eosinophils. Pero the greatest increase in eosinophils can only be found in your Trichinella spiralis. Okay, all right. Increased eosinophils. Can also be found in ascaris, pero the greatest increase can be seen in Trichinella. So, na-increase imuhang ascaris, ang eosinophils ascaris, pero dili na siya kadaghan. Okay? Alright, ayan. Now, charcot leading crystals, of course, as we have mentioned, breakdown products of eosinophil. Alright, okay, sige. Next, kung adult, no, erratic, no, pwede siyang mumigrate to other sites. Pwede siyang mabot sa kidney, sa appendix, no, pwede po siyang mabot sa brain sometimes. Mabot na po balik sa lungs, especially if heavy ng infection. So the adult, they form a bolus. This is a group of adult worms. So pwede silang magkumpul-kumpul, no? They form groups, no? Mag-clump sila, and that is known as your bolus, alright? Now, yan, sarap, no? And this bolus, no, if magkumpul-kumpul sila, especially sa intestine, it can cause obstruction, no? So, intestinal obstruction. So meaning, mag-blockage imuhang intestine, alright? Possible na, dili na kang makalibang, no? Pwede na kang mag-further infect or mag-possible na mag-destroy dyan ang intestinal tissue, which can lead to death, okay? So muna siya, in heavy infections. So bolus, no? Group of worms, kumpul-kumpul sila, it can cause intestinal obstruction or obstruction sa organs kung asa sila, okay? So here's an example, group of adult worms. Ayan, di ba? So you can see, ang sarap, para siyang pansit kanto. Joke lang. Bum each. Joke lang. Pasintawi sa mga kumakain. Tsaka, ay mo, lunch pa, dyan mo. Sorry naman. So, I suggest na dili sa mo mag-ichiraku. Or dili sa mo mag-pansit. Okay? Sorry naman. Pasensya. Sorry kayo. Okay. Alright. And of course, as mentioned, the adults can migrate to other tissues. No example, hepatic sa liver. Pwedeng sa kidney, appendix, and pleural cavity. So, ayan. As you can see, sarap talaga. Kulang na lang spaghetti sauce. And joke lang. Sorry. Ayan. So, those are your adults. No? So, ascaris adults. Gikan sa intestine of a patient that's heavily infected with ascaris. Okay. So, muna siya akong chika. So, sa ako ang rotation sa Soto, internship sa Soto, na ay autopsy, no, na nahitabo. Pero sadly, dili ko histopath ato na section assigned. So what happened is wala ko naka-assist ng autopsy. Sa Galliaris, wala ko ka-assist for daghang autopsies na nahitabo. Usually, mga autopsies, mahitabo siya sa mga public hospitals. I'm not sure if sa private na, I think na aman. Pero based on my experience, usually sa public hospitals na ay autopsy. And if ikaw ang intern sa histopath, no, usually pwede ka maka-assist and additional points na siya sa imuhang hours, whatever. Sa internship. Buhon, if maka-experience mo. Pero ako sa Soto, I heard. Dili ako ang naka-assist. But there was this child, mga 5 years old, no, nag-autopsy. And then, pag-autopsy, pag-open sa pathologist, nakita nila na daghan kayong ascaris worms. As in, daghan kayong ascaris. Like, ni kalat na siya, ni disseminate na siya to other organs. Sa lungs, pag-open nila na, sa eyes po na or like everywhere daghan gyud siya, and that's the cause of death. Muna lang COD, dili cash on delivery. Muna yung cause of death sa bata. No, it's ascariasis, like heavy gyud. Apil po to Loeffler syndrome / disseminated ascariasis, parang ganun ilahang diagnosis. Kay grabe na gyud daw, it's everywhere, no? So mura po yung chika sa akong friend na naka-assist. So inato siya ka intense, no? So possible na mahitabo po if daghan na kayong ascaris, pwede siya magawa sa imong mouth, pwede siya magawa sa imong nose, no? Sa ears po if intense na gyud kaayo ang ascaris, okay? And as you can see again, daghan kayong adults na pwedeng ma-produce, all right? Because daghan pong eggs na pwedeng ma-produce, all right? So pwedeng daghang adults na ma-produce, all right? Somewhat if heavy infection. So again, magkumpul-kumpul sila, they form bolus, and this group of bolus, no, they can obstruct the intestine and even other organs kung maadto sila. Okay? All right. So as you can see, ayan, tawge. Charot. Sulod sa lumpia na tawge, charot. Or spaghetti, sarap. Okay? Sige. So that's for the symptoms and pathology of ascariasis. So if ever magani dili siya matambalan, of course, it can lead to death. Okay? All right. Kailangan din siya matambalan. Okay. Samot na if heavy infection. Okay. All right. Sige. Now we go now to prevention and control, of course, not only for ascaris but the soil transmitted helminthes or helminthiasis or STH. We have a mnemonic, washed. No, so safe water, environmental sanitation, S, hygiene education, H, and then D is of course deworming, especially among children in endemic regions, especially in the Philippines where ascaris is endemic, like common jud ang ascaris. So it's important na these children, no, especially mga children yun, kay diba, they like to play in the soil, in the wherever, so possible yun na sila yun ang common na ma-infect, no? So it's best that you educate them. Educate also the parents as a mga proper sanitation, proper disposal of waste, human wastes, no? And safe water pod, and of course, deworming. So again, still a long way to go. Okay, daghan kayo pang kailangan i-improve, but muna siya mga ways to prevent, especially mga soil transmitted helminths. Okay. Now, lab diagnosis, of course, routine ONP, of course. Diagnostic stage are the eggs, as we have mentioned. If the stool exam is negative, there could be three reasons. Number one is wala infection, of course. Okay, negative man sa eggs. Aside from that, it could be early infection pa lang, wala pa eggs na nalay. And aside from that, possible na all male worm infection, meaning wala females. Kaya of course, di ba, the females produce the eggs. And if wala female na worms, then kinsa may produce sa eggs, di ba? Kinsa may fertilize sa male if wala female, di ba? Ayan. So these are the possible reasons kung why negative. Excuse me, why negative ang stool exam? Wala kayo nakita ang eggs ascaris. Okay, alright, ayan, sige. Next, other methods, of course, the CATOCAS, CATOFIC, we have discussed about that. Diba? Usually, the CATOCAS, CATOFIC are for the soil transmitted helminths. Kinsa gani nilang duha ang quantitative? Nako, let's
CATOCAT.
See.
CATOCAT.
Kinsa?
CATOCAT. Ang? CATOCAT.
Dili ba ang CATOFIC?
Dili.
Dili, final na.
Final, okay.
All right, very good. That is correct. CATOCATS ang quantitative. Okay? All right. So again, kinsa ganitong iyang clearing agent na ginagamit for CATOCATS or CATOFIC?
Glycerin, sir.
Glycerin.
Galing, ha? I love that. Very good. Glycerin. Okay? And unsay purpose sa imong green cellophane or malachite green gani?
Minimizing the brightness of the microscope.
Sir. Ano to?
Minimizing brightness of the microscope.
Okay. All right, very good. Minimize brightness or protect the eyes, diba, of the examiner from the light sa microscope. Very good. Okay. All right, so again, CATOCATS, CATOFIC. Next, your concentration techniques, diba, your FECT, your zinc sulfate flotation, no? But your unfertilized eggs, of course, they do not float in zinc sulfate because these are heavy, no? Heavy man ang unfertilized eggs. Okay, all right. Next, you have also your skin test, which is considered, which is known as your Moan test. That's why I can remember. Kasi magaling tayo diyan, joke. Magaling, chara. Bitaw, Moan test. Ayan, so muna siya skin test yung ascaris. As again, as I've mentioned, each parasites, they have their own skin test. So natay mga summary ana later, mga later part na sa para. So skin tests, no, again, ma-remember niyo sa inyong IS, this is delayed hypersensitivity, no? So we're testing type 4 hypersensitivity. So we're looking at mga T cells na na-react sa imuhang skin usually, and if positive ka, it means you have a prior exposure to the pathogen. So skin test na to for your ascaris is your moon test. Ayan, moon test. Nako, sorry naman. So, kayo na bahala kung sa inyo pag-remember, Anna. Di na ako mo-mention. Ay, wala ko yung mnemonic for it. How to remember? How I remember? Basta ascaris kayo, mahilig siya mag-moon. Moon test, yung skin test. Okay? Alright. And treatment is, of course, mga azo. Don't forget, albendazole, mebendazole, or even pyrantel pamoate. And the drug of choice for ascaris is mebendazole. Okay? Mebendazole, mga azoles. Alright? Basta ganyan mga nematodes, if pangunta na mo mga treatment, ato dyan mag-azole-azole. Okay? You're such an azole. Charot. So, albendazole, mebendazole. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Sige. That's for ascaris lumbricoides. Alright? Giant intestinal roundworm, please take note, no? Most common, according to Belisario, intestinal nematode affecting man, and also the most common in the Philippines. All right, Ascaris lumbricoides. Okay, all right, ayan, sige. All right. Now, additional notes. Don't forget, there's another species of Ascaris. Your Ascaris suum. All right. So Ascaris suum. Okay. This is the large roundworm of pigs. Okay. Now, of course, if you are taking care of pigs, pwede ka ma-accidental host. No, pwede mong ma-accidental ingest, accidentally ingest the eggs of your Ascaris suum, no? The eggs are morphologically identical to Ascaris lumbricoides. So, yan na yung eggs, diba? So, you can see, same ragyud siya with Ascaris lumbricoides na egg. Alright? Okay. Now, adult worms, they have a toothed lip. So, ilahang lip, kinai tooth, alright? And very important, the larva of your Ascaris suum can cause visceral larva migrants. So, very, please take note, ano yung mga terms, ha? Visceral larva migrants, we'll encounter that later. In the later part of our discussion po. So we say visceral larva migrants, but the name is of the larva migrants. So migrate siya into other organs. Unlike sa Ascaris lumbricoides na heart o lungs ra, your Ascaris suum, kung visceral larva migrants, pwede pang other organs iyahang maadtuan. Okay? So visceral larva migrants. Okay? So take note of that. Okay, Ascaris suum. And here's an example of the mouth. Ayan, na siya'y dorsal lip. Tapos siya'y toothed, no? Toothed iyahang lip. Okay? Alright. So, as you can see, tulurag yapo niya hang lips, characteristic of your Ascaris na mga species. Okay? Alright. So, Ascaris suum, large roundworm of pigs. Humans, again, are accidental. Accidental host trata. And infection is quite rare. Okay? Alright. That's for Ascaris lumbricoides. Alright. Ayan. So, before we proceed to the second worm, nato, do you have any question, dears? Ascaris, no? Again, on sa toang infective stage, yung mga Ascaris?
Embryonated eggs.
Okay. Take note ha, embryonated eggs ha. Dapat na yung word na embryonated. Okay? Alright. Yes, not any question?
Sure. Kung nganong if mag-deworm sure kay magluya ang mga students sa sawara na remember sa elementary o high school magluya.
Ah, okay. Nganong magluya ang students kung mag-deworm?
Yes, sir. Nganong magluya.
Okay. It's possible because of the side effects sa imuhang drug. Okay, nalimot ko kung saan na drug ang ginagamit. Pero most of the time, base mga azole rapod. Pero depende sa age of students, na po yung mga, they have their own kanang sana, formulation and dosage, no? Depende po sa age. So it could be possible side effects sa imuhang tambal. Okay? And aside from that, possible po na effect po siya sa drug sa worms. Okay, mo nang naluya po ka. Alright, so, ayan. So, but most of the time, it could be side effects lang sa imuhang drugs. Pero nakatry kong deworming sa una. Ako nakatry ko ha. Paano ko nagluya? So, depende na sa person or depende siya sa student. No, but again, side effects sa drug most of the time. Okay. Alright. So, very important mag-deworming po ha. Samot na yung magsiikag dula. Pero, you know, most of the time, no, kanad yung mga magdula sa gawas. Like ako, like, and, char. Kanad sa atong childhood na magdula dito ta, no, sa gawas. And then, daganta mga na chika, daganta mga, kanad yung magdula-dula ta sa soil, no. Mas ligon og immune system, no? Ang most of them, no? Kaya of course, we're exposed to a lot of pathogens. So in a way, siguro, ato immune system kayo well-primed or well-sensitized for that. So, ayan. So, childhood to na the best yun. Nakalang yung magdula sa soil and then wag everything, no? So, lalang, I miss those times. Gusto kong bumalik. Kapoy ng adulting, charot-chok lang. Okay. So, that's for Ascaris, okay? So that's the first worm pa lang natin out of how many worms na kailangan natin matapos. So hopefully, mahumanagid ta. Oh my gosh. Okay, anyway, so that's for Ascaris, okay? Ascaris lumbricoides, sige. Any questions before we proceed? Okay, na-get siyang Ascaris, dears. Medyo ano lang naman siya din naman, di ba? Alright. Sige. So we proceed now to the second nematode, and that is of course your Trichuris, no? Trichuris or Trichuris trichura. Ayan. Trichuris trichura. Ang Trichuris trichura is the human whipworm, okay? But there could be other species. You have T. suis, which is your pig, and you have T. vulpes, which is your dog, okay? Now these two species can also infect man pero accidentally, and it's not common, okay? Not usually common. Pero ang common good is Trichuris trichura, okay? T. trichura. Okay, all right. Common name, of course, is the whipworm. Whip, okay. Watch me whip. Charot, ayan. Whipworm. Habitat is large intestine. Okay, take note, ha? Large intestine. Final host is your man, kita gyapon. Diagnostic stage is ova, found in stool, may be fertilized or unfertilized. Same gyapon with Ascaris. Infective stage, same with Ascaris, embryonated egg. Motor transmission, same pa rin with Ascaris. Ingestion of the embryonated eggs, fecal aura. Okay. All right, so take note, pare-pares or give sila, okay? So, ayan, all right. Next, adults, it could be flesh-colored or pinkish, no? Slender yahang atubangan, ayan. Anterior is attenuated, meaning gamay, all right, or slender. That's why it can resemble a whip, latigo, no? That's why yahang name kay whipworm, okay? All right, ayan, dili kay sige siya sayo. Ayan, as you can see, kaning niwang na part, kani siya dears, muni siya ang front, dili dapit yahang mouth, and then ang end, muna siya ang tail portion. So as you can see, kaning medyo baga, di ba? Muna siya handle, muna siya gunitanan sa muhang whip, di ba? And ang front mismo is the latigo, the whip. That's why it's considered as a whipworm. Muna yung name kay whipworm. Okay? Whip. Muna siya latigo. Okay, alright. Spank me. Charot. Spank me, Jadzy. Ganong level. Charot. Sakita ano, oy. Charot. Joke. Not based on experience. Joke lang. Anyway, all right. So anterior 3/5 portion of your adults, it has an esophagus that resembles a string of beads. Ayan. So as you can see, muna siya yung esophagus, string of beads. So the esophagus is known as your stychosome. Ayan, nasa pangalan. And individual cells are known as stychocytes. No, so stychosome. Ay, wala pa ko nag-erase. Erase. Sorry naman. Okay. Tapulanan ako, galing ko. Okay. Alright. So you have stychosome is the esophagus, ang pangalan. And individual cells are known as stychocytes. Okay? Alright. So later, ito na ma-discover usob in another worm later. Okay? So stychosome, stychocytes. Okay, alright. String of beads. No? So marasyag, kanang beads, no? Beads. Ay, joke. Beads. No? Kanang marag sa rosary, no? Beads. Inana. String of beads. So the adults are rarely recovered because what happens is your Trichuris mo attach, no? Mahilig siya mo attach, no? Paspas siya mo attach. Charot, Trichuris ba ako? Charot, joke lang. So rarely recovered siya from the stool because your adults are attached to the small to the intestine, okay? To the wall of the intestine. Okay, all right. Next, of course, we go now to eggs. Ayan, barrel shape described or pwede put football shape or lemon shape, okay? Take note ha, football shape, lemon shape. So kung nematodes, lemon-shaped si Trichuris. Kinsa itong sa protozoa na naay lemon-shaped cyst. Nako? Na-remember pa ba? Lemon-shaped cyst? Kinsa man to? Ala, wala nag-yard. Lemon-shaped cyst?
Chylomastix Miss Nelly, sir.
See? Kinsa?
Chylomastix Miss Nelly.
Very good! Si Chylomastix Miss Nelly. Kinsa to? Mag-light ito siya na voice.
Ash, sir. Si Josh.
Ash, ikaw to Ash. Yes, galing. Sir. Si Heart to Lung Migration, I love that. That is good, no? Ash, magaling. That is, again, Chylomastix, Mesnili, don't forget, atong mga flagellates, no? Basta lemon-shaped na cyst, okay, lemon-shaped cyst, nako, press the buzzer, Chylomastix, Mesnili. Pero kung lemon-shaped egg, okay, lemon-shaped egg, possible si Trichuris, Trichura. Alright? But again, most common na description niya, barrel shape or football shape. And, please take note, very important, bipolar mucus plug. Ayan. Prominent hyaline polar plug. So, nasa ay plugs sa both ends sa iyahang egg. Ayan. So, here's it can resemble your Japanese lantern. And, again, kailangan Japan siya ma-embryonate sa soil 10 to 14 days. Alright? According to Belisario, clayish soil. So, katamurag clay ang soil. So, moist gapo na soil, clayish soil. Okay, alright. And same with your Ascaris na fertilized, bile stain. Okay, so golden brown in color. Ayan. So, very important, no? Characteristic, press the buzzer na. As you can see, bipolar, meaning both ends, na siya mucus plug. Okay? And once mugawas ang larva, kaning plug kay mo open. Okay? Alright, ayan. So kani siya, again, bipolar, mucous plug. Okay? Alright? Unembryonated. This is embryonated. As you can see, dears, di ba? Ang sulod niya kay nag-start nag-divide. Okay? Medyo ni gawas na or merg ni kumpul-kumpul na siya or medyo nag-start na siya divide. So that's embryonated. Okay? Meaning padulong na siya larva. So as you can see, mura siya Japanese lantern. Okay? Ayan, Japanese lantern. Bipolar plugs. Okay? Alright, bipolar plugs. Football-shaped, lemon-shaped, or barrel-shaped egg. Okay, alright. Now, here is an atypical trichuris egg. So, usually, kani mga atypical trichuris eggs, usually, they are larger. More slag mo swell. Usually, this can be seen if the patient is already under treatment. Nag-therapy na siya, okay, to trichuris. So, that's why, ni-effect ng drug against the egg, so muna siyang ni-enlarge. So, atypical trichuris egg. Sometimes, in patients, again, seen in patients undergoing therapy na for trichuris. Okay. Alright, ayan, sige. So that's for the eggs, ha? Very important characteristic. Football-shaped, lemon-shaped, barrel-shaped with bipolar mucous plugs. When you say bipolar, both ends, nasa lang mucous plugs. Okay. Alright, ayan. Sige. Now we go to life cycle. Very straightforward pa rin. Your trichuris usually direct iyahang life cycle. Because again, as you can see, your trichuris, hindi siya mo exhibit og heart to lung migration. Hindi siya mo migrate to other tissues. Once makaon sa patient ang egg, no, inside the large intestine, dito na siya mo hatch, okay? Mahimong adults and then produce the eggs, okay? And then the cycle goes on. So very straightforward, direct life cycle, okay? That's for trichuris, trichura. Okay. All right. So still the same embryonated eggs atong makuha. Okay. All right. Sige. Now symptoms and pathology. Again, the disease is known as trichuriasis or trichocephaliasis. Ang old name sa trichuris is trichocephalus. Okay, that's why muna siyang ang iyahang pangalan po is trichocephaliasis. Alright? But karon, iyahang new name is trichuriasis. Okay, alright. Or also known as your whipworm infection. Okay, teka lang. Let me charge. Okay. Matindog na po ko rin para ano, ma-exercise po ko. Okay. Sige. Now, your trichuris, okay, it can cause bloody or mucoid diarrhea. Take note, diba, that as I've mentioned, the adult na trichuris, iyahang iburo or iyahang isulod ang head. Iyahang isulod ang head, iyahang i-perforate or iyahang i-attach iyahang head sa intestinal mucosa. So what happens, pag attach niya, of course, it can produce irritation, no? And also, it can produce blood pod. Okay, pag attach niya, that's irritation or pwede masamad, imuhang intestinal mucosa. So what happens, of course, produce of blood, bloody mucoid diarrhea. And because magpadayo na siya, okay, there could be weight loss, abdominal pain, and of course, anemia because of bleeding from the site of attachment sa imuhang trichuris na adult. Okay, so pag attach niya sa intestinal wall, okay, di ba, bloody, produce of bleeding. So kung possible na padayon ang bleeding, alright, or prolonged ang infection, chronic infection, then of course, it can produce anemia, no? Especially in heavy infections, there could be 0.8 to 8.6 ml of blood loss each day, alright? Ayan, that's why it can cause anemia. Rectal prolapse in heavy infections. When we say rectal prolapse, the rectum, no, sa atuang butt, no, the last portion of your colon, mugawas, no? Mawala iyahang attachment to the tissues surrounding, mugawas siya, mo-prolapse. Mugawas siya sa mga anus. Okay? So, muna siya. Rectal prolapse, heavy infection. Okay. Alright. Aside from that, that's an example. So, again, pasintabi sa mga kumakain dyan. So, that's a portion of rectum na nigawas na sa anus. And sa rectum mismo, makakita kang trichuris na adults. Okay? So, take note. Heavy infection. Because again, di ba, sige siya, ga-attach sila sa mga intestinal mucosa, di ba? Na iyahang di-penetrate. So, what happens, of course, sige ga-irritate, mawala ang sense of parang attachment sa mo intestine to the wall surrounding it inside, di ba? So what happens is, of course, mugawas ang rectum. Mugawas na siya. Rectal prolapse. Mugbigay na siya ba? Mug-give up na siya. Ganun. So it goes out, okay? It goes out of your anus, that's rectal prolapse. And surrounding the rectum are adults na mga trichuris, okay? Alright. So pasintabi sa mga kakain dyan. Sorry naman. Okay. Alright. Now, petechial hemorrhage, as mentioned, because na yung mga bleeding na mahitabo sa pag-attach sa imuhang adult worm, it can be a good site for Entamoeba histolytica. Because again, your EHIS, di ba? Recall, they like RBCs, di ba? Mo ingest ang trophozoite of RBCs. Okay? All right. Ayan. That's for Entamoeba histolytica. And of course, infections with over 5,000 Trichuris eggs per gram of feces, usually symptomatic siya. So, kanang atong mag-calculate, di ba? Sa cat-to-cats, di ba? And to determine the intensity of infection, kung 5,000 siya, eggs per gram of feces, symptomatic na ang patient. Okay? Alright. So, take note of that, ha? Trichuris and Trichura, very important thing that I remember, or ako dyong i-remind myself kung Trichuris Trichura, is rectal prolapse. Iyahagi ng rectal prolapse, no? Basta gani, ang question kay rectal prolapse, naku, press the buzzer, Trichuris Trichura yan. Okay? Alright. Sige. Alright. Of course, Lab BX, still the same, parehas siya with your Ascaris, routine ONP examination gapon. Diagnostic stage are the eggs. But this time, eggs are quantitated. Okay? It's recommended that we quantitate Trichuris eggs because light infections lang, kung gamay ra kayo ang eggs, okay, dili siya makakos ng infection kaayo. Kung light light infection lang, kung gamay ra ang eggs, that's why we have to quantitate. Kaya kung light infection lang, kung gamay ra gyud ang eggs, usually, we don't give treatment. Okay? Munay gibention sa references, ha? Okay? Kung light infection, then we don't usually give treatment. That's why we need to quantitate. Kung heavy infections na, dito na tamuhatag og tambal. Okay? Alright, ayan. So, but in the Philippines, usually, dito mo quantitate, no? So, bahala gamay pa or daghan ang worms, ang eggs na makita. Diretso tang hatag og tambal. Okay? So, prevention ta, prevention. Ganun, okay? And of course, cut-to-cuts, cut-to-thick, and concentration techniques. Very important treatment nato is still the same mga azole. Mebendazole and albendazole. Okay. Alright, ayan. So, that's for Trichuris, Trichura. Again, so very straightforward lang, no? Very important to take note, rectal prolapse. And it can also happen that pwede siya magka-develop ng anemia because again, of the fact that the adult Trichuris worms will attach itself on the wall of the intestine. And what happens is ma-irritate, no? Bleeding can happen. So, if chronic ang infection, magpatuloy bleeding, of course, there is blood loss. Okay? And it can contribute to anemia. Okay? Alright. And weight loss, no? Abdominal pain, patient will also kanang magniwang, no? Because again of that. Alright? Ayan. Okay. So, Trichuris, Trichura. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Sige. Alright. Sige. So, before we proceed to the next, hookworms. Ayan. Do you have any question? Ka-air ko na din, pero gisingot na gyapon ko siya. Oh my gosh. Charat. Okay. Again, ang sa itong infective stage sa Ascaris lumbricoides?
Embryonated eggs.
Okay. Murag, ikaw po yung nag-git si Earl Tubag, no? Embryonated eggs. Iban dyan, mag-answer din naman kayo. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Sige. Mode of transmission for Trichuris? Mode of transmission? Nako. Bagal. Charot. Mode of transmission for Trichuris?
Ingestion
of embryonated eggs. Okay. Ingestion of embryonated eggs. Common name sa imuhang Trichuris?
Lipworm.
Okay. Alright. Kinsa kanitong lemon-shaped cyst?
Chylomastix
mesnili. Don't forget. Very good. Okay. Alright. Sige. So, any questions before we proceed? Alright. Okay. So we're now on the third helminth, the third nematode, and that is your hookworms. Ayan. So hookworms, according to, I think sa Zybig, the second most common helminthic infection reported in humans. Okay, so siya daw second lang. Siya ang second option. Charet. Okay. Now, it has a worldwide distribution, and the main two species that infect humans are Ancylostoma duodenale and Necator americanus. But there could be a lot of other species, no? Starting first, again, with Ancylostoma duodenale, which is also known as your old world hookworm, okay? And iyahang mouth contains two pairs of teeth. So later, ito na siyang i-differentiate. Next, Necator americanus, by the name itself, is known as your iyahang common name, American hookworm or American murderer. Please take note there, American murderer, American hookworm. Nasa pangalan na, Necator americanus. So murag Necator is parang murderer. Ayahang translation. So, Necator americanus. American murderer, American hookworm. Or, siya po ang New World na hookworm. Now, ayahang mouth contains semilunar cutting plates. So, how do I remember kung kinsang Old World and New World? So, kung kinsang letter N, siya ang New World. Okay? So, Necator americanus, letter N, so siya ang New World. Ayan. So, New World hookworm. Okay? And Ancylostoma, siya ang Old World. Ayan. So, Letter N, kung isang letter N, siya ang New World Hookworm. Okay? Alright, ayan. Sige. Later ko na i-share ang mga mnemonics, ani. Later, sa later parts. Don't worry, natin mnemonics for that. Of course naman. Okay, charot. Okay, so that's for Ancylus Toma Duodenale and Necator Americanus. The two main species affecting humans. Pero napay other species, you have Ancylus Toma Ceylanicum, which is an emerging human parasite in some regions. But most of the time, it infects your animals. Next, of course, you have Ancylus Toma Brasiliense, which is your cat hookworm. And this time, two pairs of teeth siya, pares siya with Ancylus Toma Duodenale. And then, lastly, you have Ancylus Toma Caninum, nasa pangalan na, the dog hookworm. This time, three pairs siyahang teeth. Okay? Alright, so Ancylus Toma Brasiliense, the cat hookworm, and Ancylus Toma Caninum, the dog hookworm. So, nasa pangalan na, Caninum, canine, di ba? Dog, Brasiliense, cat. Okay, alright. So, please take note of that. Sige. So we'll go now to the differentiation sa tuka species. All right, so don't worry, natin mga mnemonics for that. Okay, so habitat for the hookworms is your small intestine. Final host is your man. Diagnostic stage is ova or pwedeng larva. Infective stage this time is the L3 larva, or also known as the filariform larva. And the larva is sheathed. Okay, na siya'y covering. All right. Now, mode of transmission is skin penetration. Ayan. So, dito na nag-differ. Ang Ascaris trichuris, same sa like infective stage na egg, embryonated egg. But for hookworm, different na. L3 larva na, filariform larva, and the mode of transmission is also different. Skin penetration. Okay? So, skin penetration. So, penetrate yun siya sa skin. No? Iyahad yung buslutan ang skin. Alright? So, usually, it's through unprotected feet. So, kanang mag-walk o barefoot. No? Kanang mga magtiniil, no? So especially magdula ka, di ba? Sa una, mga katuntumbang preso, yes, di ba, na slippers imong gamiton para magpatumba og kan, di ba? So ina na mga dula, especially, di ba? Magtiniil madyuka na. So very prone to hookworm infection. Because again, mode of transmission of hookworm, skin penetration. Okay? All right, ayan. Take note of that. All right. Sige. Now we'll go now to the characteristic, no? Differentiation of the two. So we'll start first with adults, no? Since we're talking about Necator and Ancylus Toma Duodenale, because again, they're the two main species affecting humans. All right. So again, common name, please take note, diba? New World or your American murderer, nasa pangalan na American hookworm, New World, kinsa tong letter N, siya po ng New World, so si Necator Americanus. And Ancylus Toma is of course the Old World hookworm. The shape, as you can see, is S-shaped, okay? And for Ancylus Toma is C-shaped. Now, for buccal cavity, meaning yung mouth, okay? Yung mouth, how do we remember? Kung cutting plates, okay? Si neck cut. Okay, ayan. So, neck cut, tor, di ba? Cut, siya ang naay, cutting plates. That's how I remember. So, neck cut, tor, neck cutting plates. Ayan, so, that's how I remember. So, neck cut, tor, cut, siya ang naay cutting plates. Okay, so cut. Okay, cut. Okay, Necator Americanus, neck cut, cutting plates. Okay, and of course, ang teeth kay si Ancylus Toma Duodenale. So that's how I remember. Okay, so neck cut, cutting plates, neck cutting. Diba? That's how I remember. Neck cut, necator, cutting plates, Ancylus Toma, your teeth. Okay, all right. Next, you have copulatory bursa, meaning this is an organ for reproduction, some males. For Necator, it's bipartite, meaning duhara ka digits, okay? And then, bristle-like iyang appearance. For Ancylus Toma, tripartite, tulo ka digits, and simple, not barbed. So as you can see, illustration, that is the mouth. So again, cutting plates, Necator, Americanus, teeth, okay? Two pairs of teeth, again, is your Old World hookworm or Ancylus Toma Duodenale. So again, Old World, New World, deers, again, depending na siya sa geographic region. That's why it's called New World, Old World. So kung Old World, di ba, again, kato na siya mga sa Europe, the pit, di ba, na. Kung New World's America, di ba, that's how they distinguish before, di ba? That's why they're called Old World, New World. Okay? Alright, ayan, sige. So that's for the difference. Ha, again, take note. New World, kung kisa yung letter N, siya ang New World. So Necator. Okay? And cutting plates, Necat, okay? Cutting. Okay, so Necator, my cutting. Okay, neck cut. Okay, all right. Please take note of that. All right. Okay, sige. Now, for the adults, usually the Ancylus Toma Duodenale ang larger na adults compared to Necator. Okay, all right. Ayan, sige. So, for pictures, grapon, ayan. So, that's how we differentiate. So, para mas makasabot sa mga copulatory bursa, So for ancestomas, you can see, iyahang kaning copulatory bursa, as you can see, ni-split siya at the base, meaning sa medyo sa end na, na portion. And as you can see, pag-split niya, pila ka buhok. 1, 2, 3. That's why it's called tripartite. Whereas for necator, ni-split siya sa tip. As you can see, ni-produce siya og duha ka digits. You have 1 and 2. That's why it's called bipartite. Okay? Alright, that's for the copulatory bursa. Now for, ayan, for electron microscopy, sa duha ka hookworms. For necator, as you can see, semilunar. Semilunar meaning murag half siya sa moon, di ba? Semilunar cutting plates. Okay? And for ancelostoma, you have teeth. Okay, so very scary, no? Scary siya actually lang tawon, no? Ganun. So that's for the hookworms, no? Electron microscopy na appearance or yahang mouth. Okay? So again, cutting plates, neck cut, no? Neck cutting, neckator, okay? And ancelostoma doon na nalit teeth. Okay, alright, sige. Now we go now to your adult pa rin. As you can see, neckator, yahang copulatory bursa, this one is bristle-like. Diba? As you can see, bura siya na bristles. But for ancelostoma, as you can see, dili kayo na naka-prominent. It's simple. Okay? Alright. Ayan. That's how we differentiate the adults of hookworms. Okay? Take note. Very important lang to take note is the buccal capsule. Unsa na mga type of organs or unsa na type of teeth ang naa nila. Basta gani, cutting plates, cutting, cut, necator. Okay? And then for ancelostoma duodenale, teeth. Yun. Tango, not just like teeth. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Sige. Now we go now to your eggs. For eggs, same for all species, alright? As you can see, it's indistinguishable, okay? But most of the time, ang ancelostoma ang larger unta. Pero, by morphology, good, when we examine, we don't, we cannot differentiate the two species. That's why, if makakita taani, we report that as hookworm species, eggs, seen in stool sample, ganun, okay? So, reporting usually, we don't put the species, we just say hookworm species seen, diba? That's how we report. Because again, by morphology alone, we cannot distinguish. Okay? Alright, ayan. Ovoidal, thin-shelled, and colorless. And take note, there's a space, nasa space, sa imuhang shell, and then sa embryo, developing embryo. So as you can see again, there's a space, no? Na clear space yun between the shell and your embryo na developing. Okay. Inside is a germ cell in fragmentation, meaning these are embryo na nag-divide na. Okay? So 2 to 8 blastomeres or na uban na 8 to 32, no, depende kung pila siya ga-divide. Okay? So ga-divide sila padulong na mahimong larva. Okay, ayan. So morula ball formation. Egg survival and larval development, again, same regapon, moist, warm soil, usually sandy loam. Okay? And the larva will hatch from the eggs within 1 hour. Ay, sorry. Ayan. Okay. Nakita na ko, dears. Okay ra. Okay. Sorry. So, may tumawag kasi. Anyway. Alright. So, again, 2 to 8 blastomeres, no? And the soil, sa soil pa rin siya needed, no? Sa soil, gapon siya mature. Para siya siya with the rest, Ascaris and Chycaris. Okay? Alright. But again, ha, different lang yun is the fact that your hookworm can be transmitted through skin penetration and the infective stage is, again, your filariform larva. Okay? L3. Alright. Please take note. Okay. Now, we go now to your larva. L1, your rabbitiform. This is known as your first stage larva. It's short and stout and it's the feeding stage. Siya ang larva na mangita og food. Okay? Siya ang feeding stage sa imuhang hookworm. Alright. Long buccal cavity and short or small genital primordium. Please take note of that, dears. Okay? Long buccal cavity, meaning, you have dako siya ang baba, okay? Pero gamay siya og genital primordium or gamay siya og notch. Sorry naman, happy sleep. Dako siya ang baba, pero gamay iyahang genital organ, okay? Please take note. Alright, so that's for rabditiform larva of your hookworm, okay? So, rabditiform larva, hookworm, okay? That's the first stage. Diba? As mentioned, ay 4 stages of larva. And usually, L1, L3, ato ang gina ma-recover sa samples. So, L1 is the rabditiform. So, by the name itself, rabditiform, siya ang feeding stage. Okay? Short and stout. Okay? Long buccal cavity. Alright. Short, small genital primordium. Okay. Alright. Sige. Next, you have L3, the filariform larva, which is again the infective stage. That's the third stage larva, dears. Please change lang dira. Marag second stage ako nabuta. third stage larva ni siya. Long and slender this time, and it's now closed mouth. So it's the non-feeding stage, no? Because it's in preparation of for para mahimong adult. Okay, so di na siya mukhaon, non-feeding stage. Okay, all right. So sheathed pointed tail. Please take note. Kaya ako magipang bold. Muna siya tong gamiton later when we go to the differentiation between strongy and hookworm. Okay, all right. Sige. Sheathed pointed tail for your hookworm. Ah, okay. All right. Sige. Na filariform larva. Sheathed pointed tail. All right. Okay. Sige. Now we go na to life cycle. Very straightforward pa rin. Skin penetration. So pag penetrate sa L3 larva, again, mupenetrate sa skin, okay? And your skin contains a lot of mga proteins, diba? Hyaluronic acid, no, mga collagen, M. So your hookworm will produce enzymes against that. So your hookworm produces actually hyaluronidase, okay? Hyaluronidase, diba? Which is a common enzyme found also by in other bacteria. Your staph and strep also produce that. Because again, to destroy, okay? Or to degrade hyaluronic acid found in the skin, okay? Hyaluronidase. So, ma-resecrete ang hookworm, ana. Para again, makapenetrate siya sa skin barrier sa mga enzymes sa skin, no? Or proteins. So, once ma-penetrate na niya, of course, the hookworm larva will then be transported sa imuhang blood vessels, no? So, penetrate sa skin, padlong siya sa lymphatics and blood, and mabot siya sa lungs. So, ma-exhibit siya po siya og heart-to-lung migration. So, please take note. So, same siya with Ascaris, di ba? Heart-to-lung migration, no? Magabot sa lungs, mature, ato sa pharynx, katul, i-cough sa patient, balik siya sa small intestine or sa imuhang intestines, dito na siya mature. Okay? Ayan, as adults. Ayan. And then produce the eggs, and then the cycle goes on. Ganun. Okay? So that's for the life cycle of hookworms. Exhibits gyapon og heart to lung migration. Okay. Alright. Ayan. Sige. Now, for symptoms and pathology, for larval penetration, if human hookworm, necator, or ancylostoma, you have an allergic reaction at the site of penetration. This is known as ground itch or dew itch, water sore, or mazamora. Okay? So ground itch, meaning katul, no? pag penetrate, ground itch. Or dew itch, because dew, usually, mahitabo po daw siya if daghang dewy, no? dewy ang imuhang environment. Meaning, naika ng mga water sa imuhang environment. Okay? So dewy. Makita na ko, dears. Okay ra. Napa?
Yes, sir. Water.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sige, alright. Dami kasi tumatawag. Charot. Akong uyap. Charot, joke lang. Feeler. Charot. Anyway. Allergic reaction. Ground itch, no? Again, ground itch. Meaning, at the site of attachment, penetration, katul. No? Katul. Okay, alright. Next, you have that. This example, ground itch. As you can see, makita ka. So, this is the worm na nisulod, no? Sa imuhang skin. Alright. Next, severe itching, again, at the larval penetration, erythematous, reddish, popular rash. Okay, that's for human hookworm. Now, for animal hookworms, the two species, your Ancylostoma brasiliense and Ancylostoma caninum, they cause creeping eruption or what we call cutaneous larval migrants. So what happens is, mumigrate siya on the skin. And pag migrate niya, nakay makita ang mga serpiginous or mga snake-like, no? Snake-like tracks in ana. Sa skin, no? Serpiginous tracts in the skin. Pag migrate nila sa imuhang skin, cutaneous larva migrants, okay? There is an inflammatory response or migration to deeper tissues if magpadayon siyang migrate. Pero makitaan yun mo na ay tracts, no? Serpiginous, snake-like tracts on the skin. Ayan, so here's an example. Ayan, creeping eruption. So in a way, same siya with ground itch. Pero ang ground itch magod kay, mura siya rash di ay, okay? Rash ang ground itch. But ang creeping eruption, makita nyo mo na ay tracks, no? Serpiginous, meaning mara siyang snake-like tracks. So, muna siya ang worm na nag-move sa imuhang skin, alright? And na mga inflammatory response na produce, okay? Alright, ayan, sige. That's for larval penetration. Next, for larval migration, of course, same ragapon with Ascaris. Sa lungs, pneumonitis, no? There could be pulmonary lesions and hemorrhage, also as Wakana disease, Wakana. Pneumonia, and of course, alveolar hemorrhage and pwedeng bloody sputum. Okay. Adult, of course, tissue damage at the site of attachment. Kaya, of course, muhok siya gamit sa iyang teeth or plates sa iyong intestine. So, what happens is, of course, nandiyan po yung blood loss. Enteritis and pain, blood loss, because again, pag and for ancylostoma, it's 0.26 ml. Wait lang, dears. Ayan, sorry. So as you can see, mas daghan yung blood ang ancylostoma. Because again, unsa may ang ginagamit? Teeth. So mas intense ang iyahang pagpaa. Compared naman sa necator na plates na medyo dili na naka-strong, di ba? So mas daghan yung blood loss ang ancylostoma. Okay? Alright. Chronic blood loss, of course, it leads to IDA, iron deficiency anemia, microcytic hypochromic anemia, or also known as your miner's anemia. Please take note, dears, wala na ako nabutang ng miner's anemia. Alright, so IDA, iron skin associated symptoms ra. Okay, all right. Sorry. Okay, all right. So necator again, eosinophilia peaks in approximately 2 months. So please take note ang ancylostoma, pwede siyang ma-transmit sa fetus, na congenital phase, di ba? Pwede siyang ma-transmit sa milk of the mother, chance mammary infections. If maka-remember mo sa ito ang first lecture, di ba? Chance mammary transmission is again through ang kinsa ma-transmit ancylostoma duodenale. Okay? All right, ayan, sige. Lab BX, of course, routine ONP examination, pwede natong makita ang eggs most of the time. All right? Of course, Rademori culture technique, filter paper culture technique. And also if your stool remains unpreserved for 24 hours, the eggs may hatch to the larva. Now, once nanay larva mo ang stool, you have to differentiate that between if strongy ba na siya or hookworm. Okay? All right, ayan, sige. And treatments to the same, mebendazole, albendazole, and parenteral pamoate. Okay? So please take note. Because again, ang next ani is strongy. Now for strongyloides, ito na, padayin na lang ta. Ito ni siyang last topic na lang for today. Alright? For strongyloides tercoralis, it's the smallest nematode infecting man. Okay? It can be a free-living organism, di ba? As we have mentioned, it can be a facultative parasite. Meaning it can be free-living in the soil. Alright? Facultative, free-living in the soil if dili siya mo infect. Pwede po siyang mahimong parasitic when the need arises or if ma-introduce siya to another habitat, and that is your small intestine. Okay. Now again, common name is your thread worm because it looks like a thread, yahang appearance, thread worm. Habitat is small intestine, final host is man, diagnostic stage this time is the larva. Okay? Because again, the eggs usually, it signifies heavy infection and most of the time, it cannot be recovered or it's occasional lang siya makitaan sa stool ang imuhang egg. Okay? Infective stage and mode of transmission, similar gid siya with hookworm. It's L3, filariform larva, and major mode of transmission is skin penetration. But, in contrast to hookworm, your strongy can cause auto-infection. Okay? So, pwede niya ma-infect balik ang same host. Okay? It can lead to chronic or even hyper-infection. Okay? So, that's for strongy. But again, same ragyapon. L3, filariform larva, with your hookworm, and ang iyahang infective stage and mode of transmission is skin penetration. Okay. Alright. Sige. Now, for eggs, rarely found. Again, same siya appearance with hookworm, so indistinguishable. It's slightly smaller. And in comparison with hookworm also, ang sulod yun sa yung egg mismo, kay larva na. Wala na yung mga inani. Wala na yung mga division. Kaayo. So larva na yun na fully developed. Almost always contained in the egg. Larva na da yun. And Chinese lantern ang iyahang appearance. That's according to some references, okay? Pero kung Japanese lantern, kisa itong Japanese lantern? Kisa itong Japanese lantern?
Trichuris.
Okay. Trichuris, Trichura. Please take note. Alright. Okay. Sige. Alright. Now, for larvae, ayan. Since we talked that the diagnostic stage, or we mentioned that the diagnostic stage of strongy is L1, rhabditiform larva, so we need to differentiate, no? Or look at the distinguishing characteristics of rhabditiform larva. So again, we compare that with the hookworm. So as you can see, buccal cavity and genital primordium atong lantawon. So si hookworm, long iyahang mouth, okay, long buccal cavity, genital primordium niya is small, di ba? Gamay iyahang notch, gamay iyahang genital organ. And si threadworm or si strongy, short iyahang baba, short mouth, pero dako siyang notch. Oh my gosh, okay. So ducks, si strongy. Ayan. So, dako, no? Big, large genital primordium. Prominent or conspicuous. So, here's an example. The buccal larvae of Strongyl, as you can see, short buccal canal. But for hookworm, as you can see, long yahang buccal canal. For large genital primordium, this one, kanisha. Okay, this is the genital primordium, meaning this is an organ na gasugod pa lang o develop para mahimong genital organ. Okay, genital primordium. Okay, all right. So it's large genital primordium for Strongyl. Please take note. Okay, Dax Strongyl. Ayan, that's our key na term. Okay, all right. Next, of course, is filariform. So of course, still the same. We differentiate between hookworm and Strongyl. Ato ang sheath and tail atong lantaon. For sheath, as you can see, sheathed si hookworm, pero yung tail kay pointed. But for threadworm, it's unsheathed and the tail also is notched. Ayan, so ang daming notch. Ayan. So here's an example of your picture. Hookworm tail is pointed. Ayan, di ba? Sharp na point. Ayan, pointed. But for hookworm, as you can see, it's notched. May nice slit. Okay, nice slit. Or naay murag slit. No, inaniyahang tail. So, erase muna tayo. All right. So as you can see, gabantay mo ang Strongyl daghang notch. Okay. All right. So again, yahang tail notch. So nasay slip ganern. Ayan. Whereas for hookworm, it's pointed. Ayan. So that's the tail, no? This is Strongyl na ay slit sa tunga, okay? And ang hookworm pointed, okay? All right. So how do we remember? Ayan. Ito, magaling tayo dito sa mga mnemonics na to. So, Dax at my notched. Si Strongyl. Ayan. Muna siya itong mnemonics for Strongyl. Dax at my notch. Actually, pwede po kamo yung Dax ang notch. No? Pero basin bastos na kayo. So, sorry naman. So, Dax at my notch si Strongyl. So, atong yun ang Dax because ang Dax, kay makita sa L1, di ba? Iyahang genital primordium. Okay? Ang notch naman sa iyahang tail. Okay? Notch tail. Okay? So, Dax at my notch, si Strongyl. Okay? So, si Strongyl talaga siya ang bukod na pinagpala. Kabantay mo, no? Siya ang strong independent woman, strong independent person. I don't need a man. Siya pag yun ang Dax at my notch. Okay? So, Dax at my notch si Strongyl or pwede pong Dax ang notch ni Strongyl. Sorry naman, bastos kayo, no? Pasensya. But, very effective. Okay? That's how I remember. Okay? Alright. So, Dax, large genital primordium, small mouth. Okay? Gamay ang ba-ba, pero dako ang notch. Okay? And for L3, no? Unsheathed ang tail and the tail also has a notch or nice slit sa tunga. Okay? All right. I hope ma-remember na ninyo and I hope nalingaw mo sa mnemonic. Okay? Dax at my notch si Strongyl. Please take note. All right? Now, for hookworm and Strongyl, because as mentioned, we cannot differentiate the two between the eggs. We look at the larva. That's why ang larva itong compare diri. Okay? So, rhabditiform L1 and L3 filariform. Okay? All right. Dax at my notch si Strongyl. Okay? Dax at my notch or Dax ang notch ni Strongyl. Kamo na bahala. Okay? Alright. Pasensya sa mga baka nabastos na kayo. Sorry kayo, no? But very effective din naman. Okay. Alright. Now, life cycle of your Strongyl, as you can see, pwede siyang free living. Meaning, and the soil, pwede siyang dilira mo create or mahimong parasitic. So, sa soil, of course, produce siya rhabditiform, produce siya eggs, rhabditiform larva, and then filariform larva. Now, for parasitic, those filariform larva na pwede niyang ma-produce, it can also infect humans. So, dagan siyang pwedeng cycles. You have direct, indirect, and pwede pong auto-infection. So when you say direct life cycle, meaning, ang stool na gi-produce sa patient, the eggs become rhabditiform, and the rhabditiform become filariform. And the filariform can infect another host. That's direct. Kung indirect, free living, no? Or the eggs that are found in the stool, mahimurang rhabditiform, mahimong filariform, and then mahimong adults. Ayan, so dili siya mo infect. And then the adults will then produce the eggs sa soil, and then balik na po rhabditiform and then filariform. And then the filariform, once na humans, dito siya mo infect. So indirect life cycle. Dili siya dayon ni infect sa humans. And the third one is auto-infection. So the patient already has the larva, and the rhabditiform larva will then penetrate the intestine, di ba? Ayan. And then mugo siya to the other organs. Okay? Because again, it can still exhibit heart-to-lung migration, imuhang Strongyl. Okay? And that is auto-infection. Meaning, gikan mismo sa same host, same person, same host, ni-infect na po siya balik. No? Nagbalik-balik ra within the same host ang infection. That's auto-infection. Okay? Alright, ayan. So, muna siya yung mga three life cycles sa imuhang strongy. You have direct, indirect, and auto-infection. Okay, alright, sige. Now, we go now to symptoms and pathology. This is known as, the disease is known as strongyloidiasis or Cochin China diarrhea. Because your Cochin, your strongyloides was first discovered from French soldiers that were involved in the Indochina Wars of Vietnam, dapit. So, Cochin China. That's why they described it as Cochin China because they were found again in French soldiers who fought in the war in Indochina, sa Vietnam. Ganun. Okay, alright. So, larval penetration, still the same allergic reaction at the site of larval penetration. It produces larva currents. So, please take note, larva currents is known as racing larva. So, racing larva. So, racing larva. So, paspas na galihok. Actually, larva currents is a type of cutaneous larva migrants. Pero for strongy, the larva currents paspas ang larva na mulihok. Okay? Alright. So, still the same, nana. So, naay larva currents. More siya cutaneous larva migrants, actually. So, nasa po yung mga tracks sa skin kung asa naglihok ang larva. Okay. Alright. Next, larva migration. Again, heart to lung migration. So, the same pneumonia, bronchitis na mga symptoms. Okay. Adult Cochin China diarrhea, Vietnam diarrhea, intermittent diarrhea. There could be honeycomb appearance of your intestinal mucosa. As you can see, na yung mga butod-butod na, no, more siyang honeycombs. Okay. Alright. Ayan. Autoinfection, internal, again, penetrate intestinal mucosa and will spread to other organs. Hyperinfection is an accelerated autoinfection, meaning napasagdaan siya na autoinfection. And it's usually seen among the immunocompromised. Because in immunocompromised, of course, dili naka-fight off ang immune system against the strongy worms. So possible na mo proliferate, mo disseminate ang imuhang strongy. Mas mo intense ang symptoms, mas mo intense ang disease. That's hyperinfection syndrome. Alright. And of course, chronic infection, usually asymptomatic, intermittent vomiting, diarrhea, constipation, and borborygmi. So borborygmi is na yung murag gurgling sound sa imuhang intestine or sa imuhang abdomen. Okay? So that's for the diseases of your strongyloides stercoralis. Okay? So possible again ang auto-infection and hyperinfection, especially in the immunocompromised. Okay. Alright. Sige. Now for lab BX, of course, routine ONP examination, minimum of 4 samples ang recommended. Again, rhabdiform larva ato ang diagnostic stage. Kaya usually siya ang mugawa sa feces. Alright? Because your eggs are rarely recovered. Because inside the intestine, pag produce sa eggs, muhatch dahin siya into larva. Okay? That's why the eggs are seldomly recovered in your stool. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Beyerman funnel technique. Don't forget, di ba? Katong mugamit ang funnel. And your Beyerman, di ba, can use also soil, di ba? As a sample to detect if the soil contains strongy na larva. Okay. Next, agar plate culture is the more sensitive method and according to Garcia na book, it's the culture method of choice. But for Bailey, it's Harada Mori. So, ayan, look at the word choice lang. Kung method of choice, agar plate. Pero kung recommended culture method, then that's Harada Mori. Okay? Alright, ayan. Serological test, ELISA, immunoblotting, gelatin, particle, agglutination methods. And if the stool specimen is negative for larva of strongy, then it's recommended that we examine the duodenal contents, di ba? String test, entero test, di ba? Aside from Georgia, na makita sa string test, makita po si strongy na larva and possible po na eggs. Okay? Alright, ayan, sige. Now, treatment is of course ivermectin. Ako, ivermectin, di ba? It's gaining popularity now. Kaya nagang mga gaingo na preventative measure, tambal siya for COVID-19 now because still, it's not yet proven. And ivermectin is an anti-parasitic drug for us and for animals. So kung animal ka, then might as well take ivermectin. But again, ha, ivermectin is not, it's not prescribed, it's not recommended as a drug for COVID-19. Daghan ng cases na nag-take sila ivermectin as a preventative measure and pag-test sa liver enzymes, ang ALT niabot ng thousands. O diba? So ina na siya ka-damaging. And what happens? Na-damage na ang kidney, na-damage na ang liver, and also it led to death. Okay, or na-crippled na ang body, na-damage ang organ because it takes like ivermectin because of mga fake news and all that. No, so as medtechs, nakoalam na natin, ivermectin is the treatment of choice for strongy. And strongy is a parasite, it's a worm. And COVID-19 is caused by SARS-CoV-2, which is a virus. So lahira gid sila, no? So could be na pa yung mga studies about it. Pero for now, again, para safe ta, we don't take ivermectin. Mas important gyapon, effective ang mask, physical distancing and of course vaccination. Charot, 'di ba? Grabe na 'yun. 'Di ba? As medtechs, we have to advocate for that, okay? Because we know better ato ning gitun-an. All right? So, we need to educate people, especially those that can be, you know, easily swayed by fake news, no? Or katong mga especially katong mga grassroots nato, katong wala kayo naka wala naka-study og maayo and education is limited for them, so we need to educate as medtechs. That's our role also, okay? All right, nako kanin yung ivermectin. Ako, I hate, ah, sa mukha dyan yung mga people in government. Charot! Okay, that's another chika. All right, okay, sige. All right, so that's for Strongyloides stercoralis. Now, remaining last topics na lang, we have another species of Strongyloides that can affect man, and that is Strongyloides puelliborne. Now, Strongyloides puelliborne, very important lang, it causes swollen belly syndrome, usually in children. And in swollen belly syndrome, there is diarrhea, respiratory distress, and protein losing enteropathy. So, pare siyang deadly kay masikag lose og proteins. Okay? It could lead to edema, no? Kawa na kay proteins. And of course, death also, kung magpadayon. Alright? Diagnosis, of course, this time, different siya with your Strongyloides stercoralis because the eggs can be seen in the stool. Whereas for Strongyloides stercoralis, dili makita ng eggs sa stool, di ba? Larva. But for Strongyloides puelliborne, makita ng eggs sa stool. Okay? Alright, please take note. So that's the egg of Strongyloides puelliborne. So as you can see, same siya with S. stercoralis na ang sulod niya is larva na mismo. Di ba? Wala na kayo yung egg. Di ba? As mentioned, your Strongyloides stercoralis, Strongyloides species are ovoviviparous. Meaning, pag sulod sa egg, ang sulod sa egg, larva na mismo. Wala na yung katong division of embryo or mga cell cleavage, whatever. Okay? Alright, so that's for Strongyloides puelliborne. So last na lang, mga mnemonics na itong na-mention, please take note. HATS, your sword-transmitted helminths. Ang same meaning sa HATS, hookworm, ascaris, trichuris, and strongy. For unholy three or parasitic triad, that's HAT, hookworm, ascaris, and trichuris. Nawala rang S. So when you say unholy three or parasitic triad, silang tulo ang siging mag-uban sa usa ka stool sample. So sila dyan ang common na mag-uban, sila dyan ang besties. Sila dyan ang three, tres marias, ganong level, okay? So sila dyan tulo ang magsiging kuyog in one sample. And lastly, those that exhibits heart to lung migration, ash. Ascaris, strongy, and hookworm. So, ayan, ano mo yung classmate na ash, alam nyo na. So, si ash, siya si heart to lung migration. Take note, ascaris, strongy, and hookworm. Take note ha, please take note of these mnemonics. Very important. These mnemonics are core to parasitology gear, okay? Especially sa mga nematodes. Again, HATS, sword transmitted helmet, plural sa HAT. Unholy three or parasitic triad, HAT. And then lastly, exhibits heart to lung migration, ash. Okay. Before we end, last... Ah, wala pa rin. Sige, wala lang. Alright, sige. And that's the last, no? Yes, tomorrow we'll continue with nematodes, no? Any questions, dears, before we end? Whew. Daming chika. Ikapoy na ako. Okay. Yes. Any questions before we end? Dami pa nating i-discuss. My gosh, moment na taan. Alright. Sige. Any questions? Again, sa itong infective stage, sa imong hookworm,